Hi everyone, Dr. Kalaiko here, and today this message is for anyone who does research or provides education on health disparities. So I think it's time for a fireside chat, and I mean that in the literal sense. So first of all, what are health disparities? So these are differences in health between groups of people. And what we mean specifically by that is that some groups have worse health than others. So for those of us who talk about or who study health disparities, how many of us have mentioned Asian Americans or Pacific Islanders in those discussions? Some of you now, I know, have dedicated your careers to our community, and I thank you for that. And I'll speak for myself. I have not always included my own community in these discussions. And I'm a second generation Filipina American who leads an organization that's dedicated to health equity. So often when we see data on health disparities, it looks something like this. And that makes it look like Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders have the best health out of all racial and ethnic categories. But when we compare that with our lived experiences, I know a lot of people in our AAPI community who have died prematurely from invasive cancers, for example. So it doesn't seem to match up with what these graphs are showing. So why is that? Now, I've learned a lot from the work of Dr. Janice So and her team at the University of California, San Francisco. And they look at disaggregated data on Asian Americans. That means breaking us up into our individual ethnic groups and taking a closer look. So when you do take a closer look, it reveals the information that we already know to be true. Asian men as a whole have the highest liver cancer incidence of all racial and ethnic groups, specifically being driven by the high rates in the Laotian, Vietnamese, Cambodian, Korean, Chinese, and Filipino communities. This is just one example. And there are many different factors underlying these disparities. So tobacco use is one, especially in our first generation immigrants. Another big factor is delayed preventative care. So Asians, Latinos, and multiracial individuals are the least likely to get preventive cancer screenings on time or at all. So you can imagine how this would contribute to later detection and ultimately higher death rates from these types of cancers. Now let's dig a little bit deeper. Why do you think these communities are getting screened later or are less likely to get screened? Let's think about insurance status and access to preventive health care. Do you think that people have time to take off work to get their preventive health screenings done? Many times it's an issue of balancing priorities. Many immigrant communities also deal with language barriers and even bias and discrimination from their healthcare providers. So most of the time this bias is unintentional, and we'll talk about that in another video. But overall, the impact of these negative experiences on the patients is that they avoid healthcare encounters in general. So these are just some examples of what might be contributing to these disparities. So it's really important to realize that this umbrella of Asian American and Pacific Islanders is huge and encompasses so many different cultures and ethnicities and languages and experiences. So this kind of umbrella term might be useful for some purposes, like forming political coalitions and things like that, but it's not very useful for research. So we do ourselves a huge disservice by lumping all of us together when we look at things like health disparities and economic and educational disparities and so many other outcomes. So what can we do about it? So to my fellow researchers and healthcare professionals, on our surveys and intake forms, let's get in the habit of collecting data that separates out distinct ethnic groups. Pakistanis are not the same as Japanese. Tongans are not the same as Native Hawaiians. We can either provide more complete checklists or allow people to fill in their own identities, or possibly both. Let's also acknowledge our growing community of multiracial and multi-ethnic individuals who deserve to honor every part of their identities. Simply allowing people to check all that apply can go a long way. And as researchers, it's our job to figure out what to do with that data after the fact, but that's a topic for another discussion. Now, one issue that can come up for researchers is the problem of small numbers when we have few people in multiple categories. So there are a couple of ways to deal with this. One, we can combine data over multiple years, if possible. And two, we can oversample. So that means intentionally recruiting more people from groups that we know are going to be smaller. And that is one way to boost the sample size. So lastly, for all of us who talk about health disparities, whether it's in research, academic settings, healthcare, or anywhere, let's all fix our mouths to include Asians and Pacific Islanders in all of our discussions on health disparities. We are so used to being erased that it takes a lot of intentionality to start making us visible again. If the data are not there, then we at least should mention that. It's a start, and we all have a lot of work to do to continue to uplift the visibility of the AAPI community. Thank you for listening.